Father God, we thank you, dear Lord, for blessing us today. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for your presence being always with us. As I come now in the wonderful name of Jesus, I'm asking, Holy Spirit, that you would direct, lead, and guide us through the scriptures, through your word. Reveal to us what you desire for us to know. We thank you in advance for what you're about to do in this service and within our lives and within us, Lord. We thank you in advance because you're such a great God and you're a good God, and we appreciate everything that you are doing. And we said amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes, we do, Lord. Hey, God.
Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Lord God. As I said, we're going to be beginning our reading in the book of Luke, chapter 1. A very fitting passage. I want you to put your eye on verse number 39, and we're going to begin to read our text. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Chapter 1, verse 39. In case some of you are wondering, Luke is one of the books where the chapters are long. In case you haven't noticed, you got 60-something verses, 73 in just one chapter. So when someone tells you they're reading Luke chapter 1, they got some good reading on their hands. Amen. We're going to be beginning at verse number 39. The word of the Lord God said, "Now Mary arose in those days and went into the hill country with haste to a city of Judea, and entered the house of Zechariah, and greeted Elizabeth. And it happened, when Elizabeth heard the greeting of Mary, that the babe leaped in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Ghost. Then she spoke out with a loud voice, and said, 'Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. But why is this granted to me, that the mother of my Lord shall come to me? For indeed, as soon as the voice of your greeting sounded in my ears, the babe leaped in my womb. Blessed is she who believed, for there will be fulfillment of those things which were told to her from the Lord.'" Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Give God glory.
Hallelujah.
I believe that the word is so fitting for today. Yes. Hallelujah. As we're approaching that time of the year where we celebrate the birth of the Lord Jesus Christ. Yes. Hallelujah. I want you to understand that I know that we've been talking about getting in his presence. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And I don't know about you, but that's been sticking really heavy with me about being in his presence. If you're taking any notes today, the title of today's message is In the Midst of Thee.
Oh.
Hallelujah. In the midst. Hallelujah. And you're like, well, because you know what? He's in the midst of our souls. Yes. Hallelujah. Yes. He's in the midst of our triumphs, and he's in the midst of our tragedies.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. The midst, that means he's right there. And midst means middle is what they're talking about.
Amen.
That means God's in the middle of everything. There's nothing that's happening to you that God is not aware of.
Amen.
I'm just going to preach a little bit.
Yes, Lord.
There's nothing
Lord.
That's occurring for you
yes,
that
Lord.
God's not in the midst of it all.
Amen.
In case you think that the enemy is winning, I want you to serve him notice and say, "The Lord is in the midst of me." He's in the midst.
Yes, Lord.
God, so I don't care what you're doing.
Hey,
the Lord is there too.
Yes, Lord.
Preach it, best.
Hallelujah. So we know about the word that says, "In this world there shall be troubles and tribulations."
Yes,
but the Lord God says, "I've overcome the world."
Yes, Lord.
So I've overcome
hey,
it.
God.
It's already taken care of.
Hey,
he said, "Wherever you are, that's where I am."
Woo,
he's in the midst. You must understand he's in the midst of it. And I find that it's so fitting what we were just speaking before.
Yes, Lord.
Because no matter what the enemy's doing, he's still in the midst.
My God. Yes, Lord.
He's still in the midst of
Lord.
It. Hallelujah. And I didn't even know that was going to come up, but the Lord God said, "I want you to understand that this is how powerful it is." A lot of times that we have people that, you know, realize in the storm, and I know everyone has a storm. Amen.
Yes, Lord. Amen.
And there are times and seasons. Sometimes we have more turbulent times than others.
Amen.
Amen. Sometimes you got a storm after a storm and a storm after a storm. A storm after storm. And then sometimes you have a storm every once in a while.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Yes,
and you know, but I just want you to know, just be encouraged.
Yes.
You're not by yourself. Hallelujah.
Thank
some of you
Lord.
Got some, some of you got
hey,
some
God.
Jobs going on up in here.
My
Before you get
God.
Finished with that one, there's something else. Hallelujah, but you're not by yourself. Tell your neighbor, you're not by yourself.
Preacher, Pastor.
You're not by yourself.
I needed to hear that, Lord.
Hallelujah, because the Lord got to, he's in the midst of thee. He's in the midst. He's right there with you.
Yes,
but I want you to understand that not only is God with you in the trouble, he's also there with you in the victories.
Yes, Lord.
You know, this is a healing
ministry.
Yes, Lord. And before I lean so much on the trouble, we're going to lean a lot more on the victories. Yes. Come on, in the name. Why? Because you need to be encouraged in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. I know the devil's messing, but God's also blessing.
Yes, Lord.
Yeah. He may be messing with your marriage, but God's going to bless that marriage.
Yes,
he may be messing with your money, but God's about to bless your money. He may be messing with your children, but God's about to bless that
amen,
child.
Amen.
He said the seed of your womb is blessed.
Yes, yes, Lord.
And all your children are taught of the Lord. And great yes, shall be their peace. Come on now. I tell you, Isaiah 54. Come on, yes, devil's son. Taught of the Lord, and great shall be their peace.
Yes, Lord.
Children are going to be running around wondering what I'm going to do. Peace be still.
Yes, Lord. Yes, hey, God.
Yes, Lord. Jesus. Wait a minute.
Who? Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. Jesus, hey, Holy God. Bridget, wait a minute.
Bridget.
Yes.
Bridget.
Yes. The Lord is in the midst of this.
Yes.
God says, I'm right there. And while there's a blessing that I want you to see that's taking place
in the mighty name of
with
Jesus.
The visit of Mary and Elizabeth.
Yes.
You many, many times you've heard the passage about Mary. You know that she was conceived by the Holy Ghost.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's one thing that we know that we're saved because
yes,
we believe
Lord.
In the virgin birth.
And yes, Lord. Lord. Amen.
God. We believe that the Holy Spirit descended upon
yes,
her.
Yes, Lord.
And she said, who am I, Lord God, that be it unto me?
Yes, Lord.
As you desire it
yes,
to be,
Lord.
God. I don't know about you, but that's a little sideball. The Lord God's looking for something to say, be it unto me, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
As you desire it to be. He's looking for somebody to lay down their will, lay down their agenda, lay down their plan and be it unto me
yes,
as it be thy will, Father.
Yes,
hallelujah.
Lord.
Upon this visit with Mary and Elizabeth, they were cousins. Talk to me.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Preach
These
it
sisters were getting
amen.
Together.
Yes.
But see, what you must understand is that Mary was just recently, just a few passages before, it talks about how the Lord spoke to her about conceiving the baby.
Yes,
and
amen.
Calling his name, Jesus, the angel, remember, appeared to her.
Uh-huh.
But she went to Elizabeth's house.
Amen.
When she entered the house, I want you to know when God is in the midst of thee, you don't have to see it. It's when they step in there, you can feel it. Hallelujah. A lot of people are waiting to see something happen.
Bridget,
I don't need to
Bridget.
See it. I can feel that God is doing something.
Yes, Lord.
I feel it all deep down inside.
Yes,
hallelujah.
Lord.
And surely enough, that Mary, you know, remember Mary stepped in, but the Bible says, look at the scripture. It says, Dr. Luke talked about it.
Amen,
you know, he's
amen.
A physician. He would have gotten all yes, the details. Lord. He said, well, in Zechariah, she greeted and greeted Elizabeth. And it happened when Elizabeth heard. Isn't that what your Bible says? When Elizabeth heard the greeting of Mary. She didn't see Mary. She didn't know what was going on with Mary. But Mary walked in. But Mary had something. Had
amen,
that was Mary was carrying
amen.
The living God.
Yes,
hallelujah.
Lord.
She was carrying the Jesus
yes,
who she
Lord.
Was carrying. And the moment
yes,
that she heard the greeting, she started to the baby leaped in her
yes,
womb.
Lord.
You know what? The babes will cry out if you won't cry out.
Yes,
I want to tell you, that means, look, Elizabeth wasn't moving fast enough. Her baby started jumping and
yes.
saying, Lord, the Lord is here. He's in the midst of thee. Hallelujah. I love that. Somebody needs
yes,
to take that
yes,
message right there.
Yes.
Because you must understand that the baby leaped
yes,
in her womb.
Yes.
Jesus.
She didn't even know what was going on. And at that moment, when the baby leaped, you know that was John the Baptist.
Yes,
right?
Yes
the
Lord.
The one who's to precede the Messiah.
Yes, Lord.
The one who had a calling too. That, so that don't come tell me that babies can't be filled with the Holy Ghost at birth.
Amen, ooh. Amen.
In the womb.
Yes, Lord.
That's why what takes place in the womb, you need to be careful.
Preach
come on,
best. Amen.
That's a little sidebar
amen.
For those
preach
of you who are caring. You need to make sure what's
yes.
going on in the womb because they experience things too.
Amen, so amen.
I'm here to tell you that the Holy Spirit filled John the Baptist
wow.
in the womb.
Yes.
Hallelujah. It says Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Ghost. Right
yes.
there, your scripture
yes.
tells you.
Amen.
Then she spoke out with a loud voice. Then she got happy. Blessed.
Yes,
I don't
Lord.
Know, are you among women? And blessed is what? The fruit of your womb.
Yes.
Hallelujah. She didn't even have to hear that she was pregnant.
Amen.
Keep in mind, she married and go to girl, I'm expecting.
Yes.
She didn't go in there saying
uh-huh.
that. She just walked in.
Yes, it.
Come on.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Virtue
when
best.
The Lord God's in the midst, you talk about divine connection.
Yes.
How they worry about
yes,
Sunday.
Lord.
You know what? People don't have to
yes.
say that when you're connected spirit, when the Lord steps in the room,
yes.
you don't have to anybody to tell you that the Lord is here.
Amen. Amen.
Oh, no, no, no.
Yes,
you
Lord.
Know, they may not, but the moment you're like, wait.
Yes, Lord.
You know when his presence, when he's in the midst of you. You can understand, you know, when people say, well, how do I know I've entered in? You know what? No one can tell you when you entered in, but you.
Yes, Lord.
Because no one can get the expression or the feeling of God but you.
Amen.
So that's why you can have two people sitting there and one getting in.
Preaching, Pastor, preaching. Yes.
We're talking about getting in. Yes. Because they have entered into the presence of the Lord. They've gotten in the midst of him. And surely, it's not to say that they won't get it eventually, but I just want you to don't let someone else be your barometer as to where God is. And listen, because just because he's right there for you, that doesn't, some people don't tap in that quick. Come on now.
Yes.
I don't know about you, but it used to take me some time to get in his presence, get in the midst of him. Hallelujah. Not knowing that he was already there, but I didn't feel him. Come on now. I have to grow up and understand that he is already everywhere.
Yes.
The Bible said that he changed not.
Yes, Lord.
So he's an ever-present
help. Lord.
So surely the thing that had to happen for me is that I had to realize that he is always there.
Yes, Lord.
He's in the midst of
Amen, amen.
The woman of God, surely enough, when she was blessed out down, she cried out. He said, by this, you are granted, she said, look, for indeed, as soon as the voice of your greeting sounded in my ears, the baby leaped in my womb. You know what? That's a beautiful thing, people of
God. Lord.
I'm desiring to be in the midst of individuals that have the Spirit of God, that when I walk in,
Lord,
that baby leaps in my
feel it. Yes,
I'm
Lord.
Like, when I'm in their presence, I'll be like,
yes,
Lord. Yes. Hallelujah. It seems like I feel better.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Lord God. The Bible said, don't forsake the assembling of the saints.
Yes,
come
Lord.
On. Because at times you can like, wait a minute. And then her spirit man jumping with the, what's going on?
Yes, Lord.
Mind jumping. Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord.
That's a beautiful feeling.
Amen,
to
amen.
In the midst.
Yes, yes.
Help me, Holy Spirit. I told the Lord I wanted to take my time with the word today because, you know, when we were just learning about love and joy and peace, am I right about it?
Yes,
and
Lord.
We said that we're going to celebrate, you know, the Lord. God is love, and the
Amen.
Joy of the
Amen.
Lord is your strength. I want you to understand that when Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Ghost, it says that at that moment, do you realize her womb was for joy? She was.
Amen.
Do you realize she got strength right there?
Yes,
Hallelujah.
Lord.
And you're like, well, what did she need strength for? Well, let me tell you something.
Preach
about
it. Best.
You see, you got to read the word and read a little bit.
Yes, Lord. Amen.
Do you realize Elizabeth was the one they called barren?
Uh-huh.
Elizabeth was the one that couldn't have no children.
Yes. Yes.
Don't you feel like she was being mocked?
She was a virgin.
Come on now.
Yes.
Come on now. Elizabeth was barren. She was beyond the age of bearing children.
Amen.
And don't you realize she needed some strength?
Amen.
The Lord God said, and at that moment, look how God blessed. He actually gave her some joy.
Filled
her up with some strength.
Amen.
Because she had
Amen.
To deal with some people. Come on now.
Yes, Lord.
Because they were talking about her.
Preach
Come on.
It,
we're talking
preach
about
it.
The same thing back
yes,
then,
Lord.
The same thing
right,
right
now.
Now.
Yes, preach
Oh,
it.
Yeah, yeah,
preach
yeah. Come on, come on, come on, come on.
Preach
same thing,
preach
same thing.
Yes.
But I want you to know, but see,
yes.
Mary also had something that she needed right there too.
Amen.
Because
Amen.
We're looking at a woman who never knew a man.
That's right.
Wow.
Amen.
Isn't this amazing?
Amen.
We got two women coming together.
Yes.
Yes.
Two women coming together.
Yes.
One man had to intervene in order for her to conceive.
Yes.
The one was conceived by the Holy Ghost.
Yes,
but
Lord.
They both had some things that they were going through.
Yes, Lord.
To me.
Preach it best.
It's amazing how God
Preach
will bring
it.
People together.
Yes.
Come
yes,
on
Lord.
Up in here. Because that
yes,
leads
Lord.
Me to my next passage in Matthew 18. Hallelujah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Matthew 18 and 20. You must understand that in that passage there, oh yeah, I'm going to be still eating right there.
My God.
The word the Lord God says, He said, for where two or three
mm-hmm.
are gathered together
yes, Lord.
In my name,
Amen.
I am in what? The midst of them.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. I want you to see that because Mary and Martha came together.
Yes, Lord.
And the Lord God was in the midst of them.
Amen.
They two individuals, cousins, not knowing that both of them needed something from one another. Hallelujah. But they both had a key focus. They were what? Trusting in
yes,
the Lord.
Lord. Amen,
she had
amen.
Something she hadn't told anybody. Hallelujah, which was Mary. She was quiet about it.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. And then you must have said Elizabeth, that was so bare. She didn't tell her all the trials that she went through. She didn't tell her that her husband couldn't talk.
Amen.
Come
Preach
on now. That's the same.
Amen.
That her husband
yes,
was the
Lord.
One that the angel silenced his mouth.
Yes,
Come on
yes.
now. You must understand. That's Elizabeth
yes,
we're talking
Lord.
About.
Preach
Elizabeth that found that she was pregnant and then her husband not talking.
Uh-huh. Preach it.
Hallelujah. Because remember, I'm going to take you back. back into the book of book of Zechariah.
Yes.
You remember when the angel of the Lord spoke to him and he said that your wife is going to be with child, and
Amen.
He was like, oh no, he was it's time
yes.
in the temple when Gabriel showed up and told him that, and he said, because of your unbelief, you're silent.
Yes, yes, yes.
He couldn't even talk. His whole voice. Can you imagine? I'm telling you, Elizabeth had something in common with
Amen.
Mary.
Amen.
They were going through something. She couldn't tell nobody that, you know, my husband can't talk.
Amen. Yes.
My husband can't talk. He can't even celebrate that we're pregnant.
Uh-huh.
He can't even celebrate that we're pregnant. And then Mary cried, I can't celebrate because mine don't know I'm pregnant.
Amen. Yes, Lord.
Come on. Am I preaching up it? Come
yes,
on.
Lord.
Come on.
Yes.
Come on.
Yes.
Talk to me now.
Yes.
I can see stuff. Jonah go. He don't even know.
Yes,
hey, come on now. I mean, I tell you,
yes,
they had
Lord.
Something that they were coming together.
Yes.
You see how the Holy Spirit bring that word to life?
Yes,
I
yes.
said, talk to me, Lord God. He said, well, two or three come together. Yes. There he is in the midst. It took those two women going through those
yes.
through a difficult time because that was difficult. But surely enough, God moved on their behalf.
Thank you, Lord.
God moved on their behalf.
Yes,
I want
Lord.
You to see that because surely enough, keep in mind the scripture says, I know I'm going back and forth, but get the CD. Take your notes. Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord.
It says that when they met together, you know how long Mary stayed at Elizabeth's house? The scripture says that she stayed there almost 3 months.
Mm.
Wow.
Come on now.
Yes, Lord.
Oh, you know that's God. When you're in the midst and the presence of the Lord, there's something about not wanting to leave.
Amen.
Jesus.
Yes,
can you imagine
Lord.
The time that they had?
Ooh, Jesus.
3 months, they said the stories they had to
yes,
share.
Yes.
You're like, wait a minute, I want you to see it in the scripture. It says that surely enough, in verse number 56 and 1 and 56 of Luke, the scripture says, and Mary remained with her about 3 months before she returned to her house. That's the mean she was 3 months pregnant when she showed up.
Jesus.
Good and pregnant.
Yes, Lord.
By the time she showed up to her home, I want you to understand that these women, that they came together, but you talk about some power.
Yes,
I'm saying
Lord.
That because when you're in the midst, when Jesus is in the midst of thee, in the midst of the joy, in the midst of your
yes,
blessing,
Lord.
In the midst of
Preach
giving
it,
life, you know, it's hard to
yes,
leave.
Yes, Lord. Amen, amen.
It's hard to separate whenever you're knowing that the word of God is flowing, that the miracles are happening, things are blessing,
yes,
blessings
Lord.
Are occurring.
Yes, Lord.
And you know what? She stayed 3 months. I don't know about you, but I know that must have been hard for her to try to separate
yes,
herself.
Lord. Amen.
To go to her house.
Yes,
you know,
so yes,
when you have all this flowing and these the blessings and your shit, it's hard for you to say, well, let
yes.
me go home.
Yes.
Jesus.
Because see, she had to go home to reality.
Amen. Oh. Amen. Yes. Yes.
Hallelujah. But I want you to understand that all that time when they were together praying, you're like, well, the scripture doesn't say that. I want you, they must have had a good time.
Amen.
You don't stay 3 months at somebody's house. And
yes, yes, right. Preach it, Pastor.
Some people can barely stay a day.
Yes, preach it.
3 months, they must have been having a good time.
Yes.
If you can hang out with somebody 3 months, oh, you got to have something going on.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. You're praying. Praise Him. Glory to God. Every time.
Yes.
Praise the Lord. You're on one accord and He's in the midst of these shifts.
Yes, Lord.
But I want you to know that they both were gaining strength. Because, see, Mary had to go back into where she came from.
Amen. Amen.
They had to go and see her and she had to go reveal herself
right.
to him. Pregnant
yes,
to my betrothed.
Amen. Ooh. Preach it, Pastor. Yes.
And I haven't seen him in 3 months.
Yes, Lord. Yes.
Come on now.
Yes.
But do you realize that God was in the midst of you?
Amen.
Do you realize that what she received at that union, what she received at that time with her and Martha, or when her and Elizabeth were praying together,
Amen.
When they were spending time, God was ministering to them, getting them prepared because He said, I'm going to be with you when you go.
Yes,
you
Lord.
When you go get to your destination, I'm going to be there.
Amen.
And
Amen.
Sheila, can you imagine how
Jesus.
Joseph must have felt?
Yes. Yes.
When he saw?
Uh-huh.
Oh, come on. This is a fitting time
yes,
for this
yes.
thing, this pageant. Well, right around. Can
yes.
you imagine when he showed them the one you put a ring on?
Preach it, Pastor.
Hallelujah.
Mm-hmm.
And you knew that you hadn't been
oh, yeah.
with her? Come
yes.
on.
Yes.
And
Preach
she's
it.
Good in 3 months.
Amen.
Mm-hmm. But the Lord was in the midst of
us.
It gave her that strength because she was able to pick her head
yes,
up
Lord.
And tell him the truth.
Yes.
I'm conceived by the Holy Ghost.
Yes, Lord.
Can you imagine what
Amen.
People must have said about her?
Mm.
Yes.
How they must have mocked her. Even Joseph had trouble.
Yes, yes.
Thank God for the angel of the
yes.
Lord speaking to men
him.
Of God.
Yes.
Because
yes.
he wanted to put her away. The
yes.
scripture says he wanted to put her away. You know, they was talking about me. He married the girl. She already pregnant. Yes. Talk to me. Yes. Is that not some wrong talk? Talk to me now.
Yes.
That's not that.
Preach it, Pastor.
Why they get? She already pregnant.
Yes.
Preach it. Come on now. That sounds like some real talk around here. Yes. Come on now. Yes. Not he want to marry. Not even his. Talk to me now.
Yeah.
Come on now.
Preach it.
But surely enough, the Lord God said, "I'm in the midst of all that conversation that I'm gonna be with you."
Yes,
I want
Lord.
You to know that.
Amen.
And make you notice that in Matthew 18 and 20 he said that when two of them come together, I'm
Amen.
In the midst of you. So
yes.
that means when they came together as women, they were
yes.
praying. The
yes.
Lord God gave them some strength. The Lord
yes.
God encouraged them for when they were going to not be right
Amen.
With
Amen.
You. That they were strong enough to handle
yes,
what they
Lord.
Had to handle.
Amen.
She was strong
Amen.
Enough to go home because I don't know about you, but that was hard for Mary.
Yes. Oh, yes.
I'm thinking about it for myself.
Yes, Lord.
Now, I don't. You know what? I bless it. Truly
yes.
enough, is Mary, because some of us in this day, but we would have left.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
We would have done. And you know what?
Amen.
That's some reality
yes.
right there.
Yes.
And you know, I pray for every young mom.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus, because when they're in the midst of crisis.
Yes.
A lot of times, what they want to run to.
Amen. Yes.
But thank God. That
yes,
woman
Lord.
Received some prayer
yes.
and prayer agreement,
yes,
trusting
Lord.
In the Lord. And you know what? Can you imagine the prayer was that everything gonna be
all right?
Right.
Yes,
you
Lord.
Know what? It may look bad right now, but everything gonna be
yes,
all right.
Lord.
You think you got
yes.
some problem? You go home
yes.
with an issue like that. Let's see what Joshua.
Preach it,
Let's
Pastor.
See what your family gonna
preach
say.
Preach it,
but sure, for you to keep your head up and
yes,
say, I'm gonna keep on keeping
yes,
up.
Lord. Hey, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Hey, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Come on,
Hallelujah, Lord.
Yeah, yeah. Come on, now you must understand that.
Hallelujah, Lord.
But when he's in the midst of
yes,
you, that no matter what you're going through, no matter how it may look, God is right there
yes,
with you. Somebody
Lord.
Needs to get that. No
yes,
matter what
Lord.
You're going through, that surely enough that Elizabeth was filled with
yes,
joy
Lord.
Because the baby leaped in her womb. Your point yes, that you need to understand is when God is in the midst of you, things are being transformed in
yes,
you.
Lord. Yes, Lord. Preach it, Pastor. Amen.
You are being transformed.
Preach it.
When God is in the midst
yes,
of where you
Lord.
Are, things that are that wouldn't have happened before
yes.
begin to happen for you.
Yes.
You start, your mind start thinking of some things
Amen.
Different.
Amen.
Your attitude gets a little
yes.
different.
Yes.
Come on, talk.
Preach
you
it.
Are transformed.
Preach it.
Hallelujah. A lot of times we
yes.
look at the circumstance, but what about you?
Amen.
Tell your
Preach
neighbor,
it.
What about you?
What about you?
What about you? Come on now.
Yes, Lord.
But when he's in the midst of things, the Lord God said, he begins to work on you too.
Right.
All of a sudden, your demeanor changes. Your character changes. Because you know what? You've been in the Lord God has said that he's in your midst. You don't
yes,
say
Lord.
What you shouldn't say. You don't.
Yes.
You're up there watching your tongue.
Yes,
you almost want to put your own hand over your own mouth. Hallelujah. You almost want to. You're doing all kind of people. What's wrong with them? I'm in
mm-hmm.
the midst of the Lord. He's
Amen.
Dealing with you.
Yeah. Preach it,
Pastor. I don't know
preach
about
it.
You, but
preach
I've had some moments. People are like, is she ill?
Yeah. Ooh, Lord, have mercy.
She's jerking and twitching like
okay.
that. The Lord, I'm in the midst of him, and I'm seeing something I shouldn't.
Yes.
Something come up with.
Yes, Lord.
They're like, what's wrong with I'm in the midst of
preach
you?
It, preach it.
Like, what you mean?
Yes,
I can't
Lord.
Look at that like you look at that.
Yes,
every
Lord.
Time I see that,
hey,
I take
God.
Me out the glory. So I can't look at those.
Yes, Lord. Yes,
I'm
Lord.
Like this here.
Yes.
They're like, my God, you don't watch people kissing? I very rare.
Yes.
It's got to be right because
yes.
if I sense anything.
Is not yes, Lord, Amen.
Like you're grown, you're 40, blah 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 blah.
Yes, Preach
it,
Pastor.
In the 50, blah blah. We gonna call
yeah.
it on the curve.
All right now.
And you still doing this? Or you, yes.
Yeah. Preach it.
Why? Because
Preach
I'm
it.
In the midst of him.
Preach it.
And I don't want anything
yes,
to take
Lord.
My spirit.
Yes,
man.
Lord.
Because if it takes my spirit,
yes.
man, I don't want to go backwards.
No,
I want to stay going
Lord,
forward.
My God.
Hey, that's what I'm talking about.
Hey,
Lord. He begins to transform you.
Yes.
Hallelujah. He begins to work on you.
Yes.
You know, miracles occur.
Yes.
Ideas
yes.
begin to pop up.
Yes,
the
Lord.
Hey,
God.
I told you, your baby's about to live.
Yes, Lord. Hey, God.
The Spirit of the Lord God, when he's in the midst of where you are, those things that were laying dormant, those things you hadn't
Don't
touched
wake up.
In a while, those things that you thought that, Lord God, you forgot about, no, all of a sudden you're like, wait a minute.
Yes, Lord.
Begin to leave. That Ooh. Testimony just comes up. Wait
yes,
a minute,
Lord.
He said, don't forget about me.
Oh my God.
He said, I'm in the midst of this. He
preach
said, I was
it,
the one
it.
Who snatched you out of that
thing.
Yes. He said, I'm the one that spared you.
Yes.
I want
yes.
you to understand that there's power of agreement.
In the
yes,
name
Lord.
Of Jesus.
There is power of agreement.
Yes,
you know
Lord.
What the Bible tells when two or three come together,
yes,
there he is in the midst of thee. You must understand that when you come together with like faith and come together with an individual but on one accord.
Yes,
the Lord,
Lord
God said he's in the midst of this.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. You
Thank
know
you, Lord.
That's why you shouldn't be moving. See, whether 10 or 1,000.
Yes, Lord.
That's all you need is one other person.
Amen.
Preach it, Pastor.
Two or three.
Preach it.
He's in the midst.
Yes, Lord.
Every time that you turn around and you pray with somebody, you're thinking, wait a minute, he's in the midst.
Yes.
Every time that you decide that you say, well, Lord God, let's pray about it.
Yes.
He's in the
Preach
midst.
Preach it, Pastor, yes.
Thank you, Lord God. They didn't do altar call, but he's in the midst.
Yes, Lord. Hey, God.
Hallelujah. And there's no prayer for you, but he was in the midst.
Amen.
Every time that you decided, I'm going to get together with an individual and like faith and one accord, the Lord God said, I'm in the midst.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. I want you to know that's common ground. Hallelujah.
Yes,
that's something that those two women share, that they had a common ground. They had a common situation that was going on.
Yes,
and the Lord God said, I will be in the midst of it.
Yes.
I want you to know that that's some power. God will begin to show up in your life. Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord.
When things were two or three come together in his name.
Yes, Lord.
He said, I will be in the midst of thee.
Yes,
in the name
Lord.
Of
Thank
peace.
You, Lord.
I want you to understand that God
Thank
said,
you,
I'm not only there in the storm. And yes, I know.
Yes,
and I come and preach on that he's in the midst of my storm. But
yes,
God
Lord.
Said, what about in the good time?
Yes.
What about
yes,
with you? You know,
yes,
yes, storms are coming. Storms come and they go.
Yes, Lord.
Yes,
but
Lord.
What about what about those moments of blessing?
Yes,
what about
Lord.
When God's trying
hey,
to fix
God.
Me and grow me?
Yes,
the Lord God said, I'm in the midst of this.
Yes,
don't
Lord.
Be deceived. The Lord
yes,
God said, I'm right there with you.
Yes, Lord.
That time almost
preach it, Pastor.
I'm right
preach
there working
it.
On you. I'm
yes,
right
Lord.
There delivering you. I'm
yes.
right there healing you. In
yes,
the name
Lord.
Of I'm in the midst of this.
Yes.
I want you to understand when God is present. When
yes.
Jesus is there, things begin to happen.
Yes, Lord.
In the name of, you must understand that people of God, that things begin to happen, Lord God. In the name of Jesus,
yes, Lord.
I want you to know that he was with us in the beginning.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Lord.
You must understand that the word of the Lord God tells
yes,
us
Lord.
That Emmanuel, what is Emmanuel?
Yes.
God
Lord
with us.
Yes.
Hallelujah. So you're wondering, so whenever he was born in the natural,
yes.
he was twice born. He came, he
yes,
had the reason
Lord.
Why the Lord God had to be born
Amen.
Into this earth realm
yes,
because he had to be take on what we had to take on.
Yes.
He had to be born
preach
and
it,
that's
man.
Why he had to die.
Yes, preach it,
Come
preach
on,
it.
Now. You must understand
yes,
the word.
Lord.
Come on, people of God. Take up your meat.
Yes,
hey,
Lord.
Understand the word that he had to be born. He had to be born in order to be the flesh like
yes,
ours.
Lord.
So that
Amen.
Way he can
Amen.
Experience. So whatever we said that, Lord God, I'm going through, he said, I know. Yeah.
Preach it, Pastor. Preach it, yes.
They left me. I said, I know.
Jesus.
He said, they lied on me. I know.
Yes,
he said,
Lord.
The stripes on my back.
Hey,
he said, I took more whippings than you.
Preach it, Pastor. Preach
something
it.
Like, I've been rejected
yes,
more than you.
Preach it.
He said, matter of fact, I'm going to tell you that you're going to leave me.
Preach it, Pastor.
He said, I know when you're going to leave me, too.
Preach it.
That's the way he said, the
it's
same
true.
Way.
Yes.
You told some individual, you can go ahead and go.
Jesus.
Preach
the
it.
Same way he said, I revealed to you, just like I revealed to my disciples,
Amen.
That there's only a period of time that they're going to be to
yes,
He
Lord.
Said, but when they're going to strike the shepherd, the sheep will scatter.
Yes, yes. Preach it. Preach it, preach it.
See, yes. that's the whole purpose. But he said, I came in the flesh to tell you that.
Yes.
Because I want you to understand it does happen. So you can't say, well, you're God. You know, you're God. You didn't have to experience what I went. That's why he died.
Yes.
He died because he wants you to know you will have to die too.
Yes.
That's why he had to get sin
yes.
because you're going to have a get sin. Everything,
Pastor.
If you want to be Christ, he went through everything that you went through.
Yes.
He went through agony. He went through sorrow. He
yes.
went through family issues. He went through problems
yes.
with people in government, people in family. He went through all those
yes.
things that you went through.
Yes.
So that way you cannot say that, well, Lord God, you were exempt. You were the Lord. The Lord God said, no. He said, I went through it just like you did.
Yes, yes.
He said, the only difference is that I sinned not.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
But I did
yes.
go through it.
Yes. yes.
I hung on that cross from the 6th
yes.
to the 9th hour.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord God. I've been crucified.
Amen.
In the natural and in the spirit.
Yes,
he said, and so will you.
Yes. Preach
Lord
yes.
God, you will be crucified.
Yes.
Yes, Lord.
You will be lied on.
Yes,
Lord. Yes,
Lord. Yes.
Because he went through it.
Amen.
But you
Amen.
Must understand that he was born so that way he can be a Christ.
Christ.
We studied
yes.
the word that Emmanuel, hallelujah,
yes.
means that God is with yes. us. That means for he's right there with us. I want you to know that even before, see, we think about just with time of Mary and Elizabeth, but the Lord God's been in the midst ever since in the
yes,
beginning.
Lord.
Yes,
Amen.
Lord.
Amen.
From the beginning
yes.
of time, he said, let us create man.
Yes, Lord. Amen.
Let us in our image.
Image.
You must understand, he was in the midst with he was in the midst of the fiery furnace with
yes.
Shadrach, Meshach, and
yes.
Abednego.
Amen.
You're like, oh, wait a minute. I
Amen.
Told you he was in the midst.
Yes.
And remember, he was in the midst.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
The name of,
yes.
He was in the midst of everything that they had to go through.
Preach
yes,
it.
There was
Preach
a fire. Yes, there was things. But
yes.
you, keep in mind, I don't want you to focus on the fire of destruction. Focus on the fire of redemption.
Yes, Lord.
Because you know what? He said, I knew there was going to be a fire.
Yes,
and
Lord.
I knew it was going to be seven times hotter.
Yes,
but he said,
Lord.
I allowed it to be that hot. That way you can get delivered.
Yes, Lord. Hey, Lord. Hallelujah.
Because you needed some hot fire.
Ah,
some chains that you had on you, yes. Then we're going to come up with a little tap. Mm. You needed some fire.
Yes, Lord.
To get you delivered. Preach it, I don't know about you, but you know, some people came. I'm going to speak for myself.
Preach it, preach it.
I didn't come, you know, willingly.
Yes, Lord.
To Christ. I did not. I came in a tragedy. Lord.
Amen. Amen.
I came in a tragedy.
Yes.
Like, Lord.
Yes.
Running.
Yes,
running,
Lord.
Away. Like, if Lord, if you don't look. This is it.
Amen.
I don't
Amen.
Know about how you came to the Lord. You know, some people, they, you know, they will. No, no, no. I don't know how I made it up to the front for the altar call.
Amen.
I remember I was sitting there and I was going through a horrible time. And surely enough, I didn't know what to do. And I was in a situation, yet when you're delivered, you can talk about
Amen.
It. Hallelujah. And I'm delivered so I can talk about it.
Amen.
I'm about
Amen.
To set some mothers free.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hey, God.
I was pregnant. Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen.
Good and pregnant.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. And I was not married. And
yes,
that
Lord.
Bothered my spirit.
Yes.
And
yes.
I